It's not coming back.
You on Sunday asked President Trump if he was telling New York City to, quote, drop dead, a la President Ford. What gives you the impression that President Trump wants to drop dead? And how much money exactly are you looking for from the federal government?
So I've asked President Trump repeatedly, not just to help New York City and New York State, but to help all cities and states get back on our feet. We have lost now over $7 billion in revenue. That's our projection of how much is already gone because of this crisis. That is the money we use to pay police, to pay firefighters, teachers, sanitation workers, healthcare workers. That money ain't coming back. The only place it can come from is the federal government. They gave $58 billion to the airline industry to bail them out. How about bailing out America's cities, America's states? And you're not going to have, this is the part that's amazing to me, Allison, and why I'm so shocked by his silence. You're not going to have a restart and economic recovery if the cities and states that lead the American economy are back on their heels and can't provide basic services. And I said this to the president. I said, I know you want to restart. I want to restart. We can't do that if we cannot even function as cities. I heard dead silence, had a number of conversations with him, have heard nothing back. And he's a New Yorker. He was. Now he lives in Florida. But he's literally said nothing about how to help the place that's been the epicenter to get back on its feet. So what I think the president should be thinking about is two things, only two things. Testing so we can actually all beat back this disease, and the stimulus to allow our cities, our states, our economy to fully recover. These are the two things he has dropped the ball on, and he's not even talking about. When you ask him, how are we going to get cities and states going again, he has nothing to say about it. You know, he wants to talk about immigration. He doesn't want to talk about what's actually happening on the ground with the people he's supposed to be serving. And I think history is going to judge him very harshly and put him in the same camp as Gerald Ford and even Herbert Hoover, who ignored what the Depression was doing to people and failed to bring the country back. That's where this president is now. And he should kiss his reelection goodbye if he thinks he's going to be able to convince the American people to want four more years of a guy who can't even get the basics right.
Mayor Bill de Blasio, we really appreciate your time. Thanks so much for being on
your day. Thank you, Allison.
So how soon until there is a coronavirus?